been an extremely difficult few months for care homes across Greater Manchester. The Heathlands Village Care Home in Prestwich is no different. It's run by a social care charity called The Fed, which also provides community support to thousands of Jewish people across Greater Manchester. Raphi Bloom is the Director of Fundraising. Good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How hard has Heathlands Village Care Home in Prestwich been hit by coronavirus?
I would say that we were hit hard by it. We locked down our care home 10 days before the Prime Minister made his announcement, so we are now on day 71 as we speak this morning of lockdown, which has been really, really hard for everybody concerned. We sadly lost 16 very, very dear residents to COVID over that period. The families have not been able to come in to see their loved ones for, you know, over 10 weeks now. No volunteers have been on site. But the real positive is that we've had 28 residents who tested positive, who have made full recovery. And as we speak, as of this morning, without tempting fate, the site is COVID-free. So I think that's the real focus at the moment, is to focus on those residents that have made a recovery and the fact that, you know, hopefully now we're getting back to some sense of normality, although we won't be relaxing any restrictions anytime soon because, you know, this is a marathon, not a sprint.
So you made the very difficult decision then to lock down 10 days before the rest of the country. But presumably now you're thinking that that was absolutely crucial. It was a crucial move and it was the right move.
Absolutely. Everything that we've done all the way through this is to put the safety of our residents and of our staff front and centre. And our village, our care home, you know, is home to 180 residents, but it's also very much the centre of our community as well. There's a cafe, there are volunteer activities that go on. And so almost overnight, there were no families coming in. You know, we had 1,000 people coming through our doors every week before COVID. So all of a sudden, you know, we went from being a bustling community centre to having nobody on site apart from our care staff. Even our sort of back office staff all went to work from home and have been doing now for over 10 weeks. So, you know, that was very hard as well. I think a lot of the time that we've lost focus on the fact that, you know, for residents of our care homes, of course we have to protect them, you know, from COVID. But, you know, when you sort of scale back on activities, you scale back on family visits, that also has a significant health impact on elderly people in terms of their mental
state health,
and their, you know, their motivation and everything that goes along with that. So we've tried really, really hard to keep our resident spirits up. Our activity team have been fantastic. Our care staff have been heroic. You know, we've also had to manage significant employment challenges because once, you know, we've had over 100 staff who've had to go home and self-isolate because of corona, and it's only this week now that we finally sort of really turned the corner on that, and I think we've got 30 staff off at the moment who are self-isolating, but the vast majority of staff who were off have now returned to work.
I know you want to say that the local people in Prestwich and Whitefield have been hugely supportive over the last few weeks, haven't they?
Absolutely. I mean, I think we are unique in Greater Manchester in terms of the fact that we run a care home. But at the same time, we look after 1 in 10 Jewish homes across Greater Manchester, by the way. So it's not just Prestwich, North Manchester, but also, you know, Hale, Bowden, Altrincham, places as far south as Hanforth Dean and Marple, and as far sort of north as Rawtenstall and, you know, sort of west as Warrington. 1 in 10 Jewish homes in Greater Manchester receives help from us. And we're talking about, especially now, mental illness, suicide, loneliness, isolation, depression, poverty, and it's been a significant challenge to our community support teams as well to help all these people. And the community have been phenomenal. We have over 500 volunteers. Another 100 have come on board since COVID to offer their help. And the support that people have given us, PPE that they've donated, games for families that are in isolation with children who might have learning disabilities and need that extra bit of help and stimulation. Across the board, local schools, St Monica's, Phillips in Whitefield, making visors and donating them for our care staff. It's been absolutely humbling.